We could start with Krishnan, otherwise, if you can start the streaming. Yep.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Krishnan Narayanan, Vice President of the IIT Madras Alumni Association and Program Coordinator for Sangam 2020. On behalf of the association, I welcome you all to our flagship event, Sangam 2020, Driving the New Normal. You know, this morning we had a fantastic set of conversations with global leaders who painted a picture of the new normal in their own areas: politics, science, research, education, and entrepreneurship. In fact, our director, Professor Bhaskar Ramamurthy, spoke about how IIT Madras will retain the spirit of resilience in the new normal. Today's masterclass builds on that idea. IIT Madras's online education, scientific, and technological contributions to nation building. This is an important topic. I am delighted to introduce the masterclass moderators to you. Professor Mahesh Panchangula, our very own dynamic Dean of Alumni and Corporate Relations. In fact, he's the person who helped craft the name, the final name for the theme for Sangam this year of Driving the New Normal. So a warm welcome to him. He is also joined by Professor Pratap Haridas from the Department of Metallurgical Engineering and one of the architects behind IIT Madras's innovative Open for All online BSc degree in data science and programming. So over to Professor Mahesh and Professor Pratap for their session. Professor Mahesh.
Thank you, Krishnan, and welcome all to Sangam 2020, Driving the New Normal, as we all know it. It's a delight and pleasure to be here today to talk to all of you. Good morning, good evening, and good afternoon to all of you, wherever you are in the world. It's a pleasure to have all our alumni log in to watch this this event today. Sangam has been growing from strength to strength in the last three editions. We've gone from hosting a small or a mid-sized event to today, one thanks to the new normal, a global event with participation from all across the world. Our alumni association has a lot to claim for this success. I think they've done a remarkable job in the last several years of building a network for our alumni that will come back to benefit each and every alumnus and alumna of this great institution. We are an association of 50,000 extremely successful professionals and individuals spread across the world in over 75 different countries, and with several alumni actually having joined the fold only in the last 10 years. So we are a very young, dynamic, global alumni association. I don't know how many universities in the world can claim that for their as theirs. And we are very grateful to the alumni association for what they do. And I'm sure each and every alumnus and alumna is benefiting from the efforts of this event and other activities of the association. IIT Madras, as we all know, celebrated its Diamond Jubilee last year in a very grand celebration that culminated on campus. We had a global celebration with alumni congregating in 60 different cities, at least. It turned out to be many more than that, but we were hoping that we would get congregations in about 60 cities. And the goal was to, again, demonstrate to ourselves this global nature of our alumni fold. During these 60 years, IIT Madras has reinvented itself several times. Now, so I want to go back to 1959 when this institution was created, and walk us through several of those reinventions in the next 15 minutes or so. The year 1959, when IITs were created, and IIT Madras, particularly in the southern part of India, was a very unique year. We were obviously not among the richest of nations in the world. We had an extremely high level of poverty. And we were also heavily dependent on several friendly powers for our technological needs. Under those circumstances, And under all of those constraints, the government formed a committee headed by Dr. Nalini Ranjan Sarkar that came up with a revolutionary report that said, let us set up institutions of eminence like the MITs of the world, right here in India, right now. So they committed significant amounts of money and resources, and more importantly, neuron time from the government. The mind share of the government was very difficult to get in those days, but they dedicated a significant fraction of that mind share to create these, what at that time were oases of excellence. There were these universities that were created, technological institutions. Now, mind you, there were several good universities at that time in India. India has had a long history of good education and research, but not in the strong, not in the fields of engineering and technology. We were quite accomplished in science, in physics, especially. We had the Indian Institute of Science that was already an institute of global importance. We had places like Andhra University or Madras University that had crafted a name for themselves on the global stage. But we didn't have technology driving institutions at that day. That was the environment in which IITs were created. And they were given one and only one clear mandate that said, drive technology for the country. It was not about educating the a generation of technology-enabled engineers. While that was one of the goals that was served along the way, that was not the main goal. The main goal was to drive technology in the country, drive the thinking behind evolution of technology in the country. There are many testaments to this along the way, and I want to show you two or three. Soon after IITs were started, and particularly IIT Madras, within about 6 years' time, we were enrolling more postgraduate students than undergraduate students. And by even late 60s, we were graduating more postgraduate students than undergraduate students. And ever since then, till date, we have graduated more postgraduate students every year than undergraduate students. This was kind of one of the main driving motivations behind the creation of these institutes of excellence, which drove technology. Now think about yourself for a minute. Imagine you are a lone engineer in your family, in your extended family, okay? Now, everybody else was good, but they were not engineers. They can't think like engineers, and you are one. What are the kinds of things you would have to do in your own family? You know, you may need to, you know, change a light bulb occasionally. You may need to go fix a leaky faucet if you didn't have access to a plumber. You may need to answer questions about how a particular remote works. Somebody may have been curious. You know, a remote control on a television works just fine, but they wanted to know exactly how it works. And you being the lone engineer in this family, are charged with answering that question, right? You may need to go build a small contraption for, you know, serving a particular purpose. You may be required to go shopping to choose the best refrigerator in the market, for example, because you have this, you know, thinking as an engineer. IITs in the 50s, in the 60s, did all of those. Imagine the industry of that day coming to IITs and asking all of these questions. They answered questions for industry. How does something work? There were a lot of projects commissioned around industry coming to IIT Madras, particularly, wanting to know how something worked. They had gotten technology from somewhere else, but they needed to understand how it worked. IITs were charged with fixing a problem they had. They changed light bulbs. Because this was the IITs of that day had professors and students that could solve the problem. IITs of those days were charged with developing new technologies that were of immediate an imminent need in the country. IITs of that day were charged with driving the research directions, the general business directions from a technology perspective for several companies. So what we consider as a legitimate purpose of a university were served by the IIT faculty and students all the way back, even in the early and late 60s. And we continue to do that. Now, IIT Madras in particular has carved a very special place in the country for ourselves. This may have something to do with the old German DNA that we inherited along the way, because we were set up with German assistance, and Germans are particularly good with engineering. And I think we inherited this thinking, and not just engineering, but they're also very good with industry-university connect. They are very meticulous about engineering industry university connect. And they brought that thinking to IIT Madras from day zero. So the German professors who were here drove into the philosophy of the institution that we should have a strong industry-facing arm of IIT Madras that would work with the industry to solve problems of relevance to them. So this core idea of what came down from the Germans exists with us even today. And it has helped us immensely. Just to give you a couple of stats, we do more industry-facing work than any educational institution in the whole country. Sitting here in Chennai, we work with over 250 industry partners every year. We work with industry partners globally through several government and non-governmental programs to solve their problems. And more importantly, many of these industry customers have not left us in decades. If you're a businessman listening to this, you'd know the importance of retaining customers. I think this core value, delivering a certain value back to the industry, has helped IIT immensely. And what we do for the industry is one part, but what industry does for us is an even bigger part. And as this relationship grew, we found it beneficial to start an IIT Madras research park right next to us. The IIT Madras research park was the first and the largest in the country. It still remains the largest research park next to a university in the whole country. And the research park is there for one and only one purpose again, to help solve industry problems. IIT faculty and students stepping up to solve industry problems. So in this whole rubric of industry relations, for several decades now, IIT Madras faculty have stepped up along the way to address key issues at every step of the way. I'll list out a few. And by the way, the best resource for a kind of a nice listing of all of these science and technology achievements is the speech that our director, Professor Bhaskar Ramamurthy, gave during the occasion of last year's convocation when the Prime Minister was our chief guest. It's about a 10-minute video. You can go on YouTube and watch it. It's got a very nice listing of our achievements over the decades. In the early years, you know, India was still building itself. Infrastructure was a big problem. Okay. IIT Madras faculty stepped up to develop a self-standing television tower made out of concrete at that time. Television towers that could be built across the country quickly and could be used for multiple purposes. So this multi-purpose television tower was designed and projects were executed by our faculty. Another important design that came out of our labs at IIT Madras are what enabled our railways to spread their arms and wings throughout the country. All of us have traveled by trains. The rails rest on concrete sleepers. Those sleepers have a particular design requirement in terms of their ability to bear those loads. The sleepers and the way they have to be assembled with the tracks was all technology that was developed at IIT Madras by our civil engineering department. Similarly, in the early days, when in the late 70s and early 80s, when telephony was picking up in a big way, we had a very enterprising group of faculty members who stepped up to solve several key challenging problems of that day to enable last mile connectivity of telephony into rural areas, into even semi-urban areas where wired telephony was difficult to take. So, and in this fashion, as we move into the 80s, and as we come into the 90s, or even the early 80s, the Defense Research and Development Organization, as well as the Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO and DRDO, collaborated with several IIT Madras faculty members on key initiatives that enabled a lot of their missions. You'll see IIT faculty members on pretty much every important committee that DRDO or ISRO has formed. Most recently, the unfortunate mishap with Chandrayaan required a detailed analysis and troubleshooting. And some of our faculty members were part of that effort to understand what went wrong and how to fix what could be a future design change. So in this fashion, our linkages between ISRO, DRDO, and IIT Madras are very, very strong, thanks to several key centers of excellence, including our combustion center, our center for propulsion technology, center for wireless technology. We have another center in secure hardware and microprocessor applications. And all of these initiatives are important to enabling a nation that is self-reliant, that is Atmanirbhar. Along the way, you know, if you ask us, is our job done? Answer is absolutely no. We have many more miles to go. In the age of universities, in the parlance of universities, 60-year-old university is just a teenager. And just like every teenager, we are full of energy. We have ambitions. We have a very romantic view of where the world should be. And we are completely dedicated to creating that world. That's our mission for the next 15, 20 years. Our faculty are involved in many ways with nationally relevant projects, including developing our own microprocessor and microcontrollers for our electronic needs. Ultimately, we want to use the research expertise that we have available within the IIT systems to drive technology and translate it into products that the country can benefit. I want to step back for a minute and talk about what enabled these remarkable contributions. If you think of who created and funded IITs in particular, it was the government of India. They were started during very difficult times. And they were started with a very clear mission to create the best scientists and technologists of the world. By the way, in this whole path, we've graduated some of the world's best engineers. We have one of the world's best undergraduate programs. There's no doubt about those parts. Who created those? They were certainly the government of India had a hand to play. They funded the institutes adequately and left the institute and its leadership to decide the best way to spend that money. I think this is remarkable. It is remarkable to think that IITs as a brand were fully funded and created by the government. I can think of very, very few such brands that were created solely by governments anywhere in the world. You can look at Europe, you can look at the Americas, you can look at China. Global brands that everybody recognizes that were created purely by government support are very rare. And we are very thankful to the government for that support that has graduated all of you alumni. So that brings me to my last thought. How long can this be sustained? How long should the government be in play to sustain this Institute of Excellence after it has created it? The answer is not for too long. I don't think it is right for all of us to be asking the government to continuously support this forever and in perpetuity. I think it behooves us, each and every one of us, our alumni out there, our faculty, our students, to step up and take charge of this institution's destiny in every way that you can. You need to come control the growth of this brand. You need to come help us grow this to the next level. I think that is where we need our alumni to step up. You benefit from this growth. You benefit from the brand as much as the brand benefits from being associated with you. So let's make it an association like none else in the world. Our alumni association is one of the best in the world. Thank you again, Lata. I think for giving me this opportunity, and I want to take a minute to introduce Pratap and talk about what's coming up next. You know, IITs have been at the forefront of education for 60 years now. We are recognized as some of the best educational institutions in the country, par excellence in every field, on all fields put together. And IIT Madras particularly has been ranked number one 5 years in a row now, and the best educational institution 2 years in a row. So what can we do with this? Is it enough if we just graduate, you know, a few hundred undergraduates and a few hundred PhD students every year? The answer was clearly no. With what we have achieved, we need to take this benefit to the masses. We need to take this to everybody sitting in every village in India and allow them a chance. Allow them a chance to come be part of this great institution. And that is what we have designed with our online degree programs that Pratap is going to talk about. Pratap is a colleague of mine. He has driven our online education initiatives for several years now. He's very committed to this effort and a remarkable person who will take this to the next level. I would like to invite Pratap to talk a little bit about the online degree programs.
Thank you, Mahesh. Thank you, Krishnan. Thanks. Hello, everyone. It's a pleasure to be with you here this evening. As Mahesh indicated, we have been doing a lot for the educational process in India. You know, IITs have been doing this for a long time. It's my pleasure to share with you what your alma mater has been doing, particularly with respect to reaching out to the masses in a big way by using online medium that is available to us. Of course, this year, 2020, everybody has been trying to use the online medium for education. And in some sense, I mean, it is good to note that IIT Madras has been taking a lead in this since 2003. So we didn't actually get into this in 2020. But we have been at this since 2003. It's my pleasure to share with you what we have been doing and where we are headed with it. And so I will show you a few slides, and then that will give you a reasonably good idea of where we are headed with this. Let me just share the screen here, and then we should be able to get going. One second. Okay, I hope you can see the slides that I have put up here. So I would like to share with you what IIT Madras has been doing with respect to scaling up the learning process, while most importantly, maintaining quality and efficacy. So, it is very important. I mean, at the end of the day, the whole IIT education is known for its quality. So everything that we do with it, the way we reach out with this education to the public, has to ensure that we maintain this quality. We have worked hard at doing this, and I would like, I mean, it's really my pleasure to share with you what we have accomplished over the years with this. I will talk of two activities that we have been doing. One is this Swayam NPTEL that you see here, and the other is this online diploma and degrees from IIT Madras. I'll scribble a little on the slides just to give you a classroom feel, so please bear with that. So as I said, the online education process started in 2003. Professor Anand was the person who whose imagination and vision helped us start this NPTEL program. And Professor Mangal Sundar, who is now still with us in the Department of Chemistry here at IIT Madras, he really worked very hard to get it off the ground and bring it to a stage from where many of us have been able to contribute to it. So first of all, why do we need to get into this? So let's begin there. First of all, the scenario in India is what you see here. We have a large number of universities. Many numbers are put up there. Maybe the number of interest is this gross enrollment ratio. It's of the order of 27% at this point. The government is very keen to increase this to about 50%. That would put us on par with many advanced countries, so to speak. And so there is a lot of interest in doing this. This means about roughly 30 million additional college seats have to be introduced. That is a phenomenal challenge. I mean, it's not simply a question of buildings and tables and chairs. You need faculty, you need a lot of other facilities to be put in place. And this is simply not possible in any small time frame to accomplish. So we have to think innovatively, and along came the online process, and we have really, I would say, leapfrogged many requirements and are now able to do something that was maybe unimaginable even say 10 years ago. Of course, we need to do all this while maintaining quality. And as you can see, there is a big challenge on how to scale up this reach of the educational processes in India without compromising on quality. So the NPTEL is the National Program on Technology Enhanced Learning. It's my pleasure to share with you that IIT Madras is the primary coordinating institute of this program. It is a program that is run by the seven IITs, the older IITs, and IISc Bangalore, which you can see the logos down there. And we are the institute that sort of initiated this program, and we are the coordinating institute. It has been operating in two phases. From 2003 to 2014, we have been creating a repository of content which people can view for free. And since 2014, we have been offering courses with certificates. So I'll talk about that briefly. But the maybe the highlight that you can see is that it is free, it is accessible by everybody. And please see here, we have over 1 billion views of our site. Considering that our population is, the world's population is less than 8 billion. Of course, a view is a view. It doesn't mean these are different people. It could be the same person viewing it several times. But just to give you some number there, we are looking at 15% if it is of the world's population, if each of these were individual views. So that's a remarkable number to look at, given the need for education. India has traditionally been, over the years, if you go back in history, has been the location where education has been our strength. Education is something that we gave to the world. People came to us for education. And it is indeed our pleasure to find our way back to where we were. And again, be in a position where it is our privilege to share with everybody education, high quality education. So this is just something about the NPTEL program. This allows faculty at the IITs and IISc to put their classroom content and make it available in the form of videos for the entire world actually to see. About 200 million of these views are from international locations all over the world. And what is special about this is that this is core engineering content. This is not simply some glossy, few slides that are shown. This is hardcore engineering content. So the kind of content that many of our viewers, many of the people who use this content have told us that, this content I cannot find anywhere. If you want something about, the effect of vibrations on underwater structures, that kind of a course you are never going to find anywhere on the internet. you will get a thorough, rigorous course of that nature on NPTEL. This is a project, by the way, funded by the MHRD, now the Ministry of Education. So what have we done since 2013? In the early days, we simply made this content available. People could learn on their own. Since 2014, what we have done is we have started giving certificates. So we have now evolved a very elaborate process by which people can view this content in a systematic manner, semester by semester, attend classes online, which are recorded classes, but submit assignments and then appear for proctored exams, in-person proctored exams. So this is very important to maintain the rigor of the whole process. So there are many international online MOOC offerings that are out there, but none of them have this feature. None of them compare with us or come even remotely close to us in their ability to actually run these proctored exams for millions of students. So you can see here, we've had about 12.5 million people enroll for our courses and 1.38 million people actually wrote our exams. So this is a remarkable number. This happens in centers across the country. So we have 200 centers across the country. IIT Madras coordinates this. Every semester we are running these courses and students take it by the millions. And they're really delighted to see this content and to learn. They get to interact with the professors at IITs. We have sessions where they can talk live to the faculty. They can ask questions live and they are absolutely thrilled. And we are also delighted to note that many of these small towns, tier two, tier three cities, have students who are able to use this opportunity to showcase their capability. They do very well in our exams. And it indeed highlights the fact that, we have excellent students throughout the country who deserve the opportunity to get access to the kind of education, the quality of education that the IITs are in a position to offer. And this platform has been a platform that has opened this up in a dramatic manner for all the people across the nation. We have also been related, we have also worked with the Swayam initiative of the government. So basically, the government recognized the kind of accomplishments that the NPTEL project attained and decided that it would be nice if this can be extended to other streams of education, including high school education, various other streams of education, because we are focused on the engineering stream of education. And so the Swayam project is basically an umbrella project which includes various other agencies. You can see here down AICT, CEC, IGNU, IIM Bangalore, NCERT, various educational institutions organizations in India. And they form part of Swayam. NPTEL manages the Swayam site because of the experience that we have in it. And we are like the main course offering on the NPTEL site. The other coordinators are, of course, learning and they are building along the way. So just to give you, as I mentioned, just to highlight what we do, you can see here courses by all disciplines. This is what is offered by NPTEL. And this distribution is itself something that you will not see in any international offering. Courses textile engineering, physics, ocean engineering, metallurgical engineering, of course, computer science courses, electrical engineering courses, and so on. So this range of courses are simply unheard of in most other offerings with this level of detail and depth. And the institutes that are offering it are pretty much the best institutes that you will see in India, which have made a name for themselves. So now the population of India can access all of these institutes for free. This is the most important accomplishment of this project. They can access all of this coursework and get certificates from any of these IITs for free. And these certificates are through a rigorous process. So many of the people who have graduated from, who have received these certificates have done very well in interviews. And we have a lot of feedback from companies, from interview panels, that students who showed these certificates actually were able to present themselves very well during that interview. We also have actually, in fact, I would like to take this opportunity to invite you to be part of this process. You can see here, we have a lot of institutions, international institutions, which have now started offering courses in NPTEL, KTH, TU Berlin, Texas A&M, and so on. I invite you, the alumni of IIT Madras, to join us please try to see if there are faculty you can collaborate with at the IITs with whom you can co-offer a course. We would be delighted to do that. We are really looking forward to having industries and various other institutions participate in this process. It will be anchored by a faculty at IIT Madras. And so if you have interest in this process, I really would like to use this opportunity to invite you to join us in this really beautiful, thrilling journey. One of the big success factors of the NPTEL process is that we have worked really personally, I would say at a really personal level, with colleges across the country. We have about 4,000 colleges which have signed up with us. Signing up simply means it's a free process, but they have some responsibilities that they have to carry out at their end, which makes them really part of the NPTEL family, so to speak. And so we have 4,000 colleges from across the country who have signed up. This enables their students to take our courses in a much more organized manner. Please note that the NPTEL process is open to anyone. You don't have to be a college student to take an NPTEL course. You don't have to be a college student to get an NPTEL certificate. You can be anybody. You can be a homemaker. You can be a school teacher. You can be general manager of a company. It just doesn't matter. This is just an opportunity available, and you can do so. But particularly the college community, which is really, at that point focused on the education process, we are able to reach out through this local chapter initiative. And a very large fraction of our exam registrations, which you can see here, comes from these local chapters. So it has really been a very successful initiative. And many colleges are now taking these courses, NPTEL courses, for credit transfer onto their transcripts and certificates. So this has really become an educational community across India. And we are really delighted that we have had the privilege, I would say, really to build on this foundation that was laid years ago on the NPTEL program and bring it to the stage where so many are able to utilize it and benefit from it. We have also more recently started something called a domain certificate, which is sort of, you can think of it like a minor stream, kind of. So in different domains, we have created these packages of courses. So instead of somebody taking these courses, individually without a particular plan, this gives them something of a plan. You can and says that, if you do this and you do excel all these in these five or six courses, then you will get a domain certificate, which sort of highlights the fact that you are an expert in that area. And we have had students who have completed this very successfully, even as far out as places in the Northeast, where usually accessing them is very difficult. Being able to access them is very difficult. For us to set up exam centers in some of the remote places in the country has been challenging, but we have managed to do that successfully. We have had a lot of assistance from faculty in various universities across the country, who have stepped up and said, we will assist you if you're having a difficulty setting up your exam process in this particular location. And that has really helped us in a big way. As I said, the whole process is free. It's completely free. There is only a costing, which is at a not-for-profit basis for the final exam, because we have to arrange proctored centers, we have to arrange invigilators and infrastructure for it. And that is as low as 1,000 rupees per course for a semester. So as I mentioned, I already spoken about the NPTEL and SWIAM model. And basically, like I said, SWIAM is the umbrella organization through which the same kind of initiative is being rolled out to the nation. With that, I would move to the next logical extension that we could think of in this process, which is our really brand new program that we have launched, which is the world's first online BSc degree program in programming and data science. This was launched just on the 30th of June earlier this year by the Honorable Minister for HRD, Sri Ramesh Pokhriyal. And we have just completed our first qualifier process. And I'm going to share some data with you. And it's really been a very exciting journey for us. So we have created, again, used all our learning in the online education process to build a very flexible and interesting program in a very niche area, which a lot of people are interested in now, which is the programming and data science area. So we have a three-year BSc kind of a program. But we have a variety of entry points and exit points, which people can come into and graduate from based on their requirements. Again, this is a program that is open to anybody as long as they've completed 12th standard at some point in time earlier in their life. They can actually do this. So there is no real restriction on your age, no real restriction on where you are physically located, and no restriction on what your background is. You could be an agricultural engineer, you could be an aerospace engineer, you could be a computer scientist. It doesn't really matter. If you find this interesting, if you think this will contribute to you in a professional setting, then this is available to you. And we have set up an entry process that is very different from the traditional JEE GATE kind of process. So what we do here, again, to make use of the, take advantage of the online education process. By the way, here also the exams are in person. Just on the 22nd of November, about 10 days ago, we conducted exam in about 100 cities across India, and about 30,000 students had applied for the exams. 20,000 had reached some basic requirements to write that exam, and they wrote the exam across the country. This is just 10 days ago. We are expecting to release the results in the next 3 or 4 days. So the evaluation is in person, and we allow people to come into the program with just showing their credentials that they have completed 12th standard. And their whole qualifier process is simply the first month of the program itself. So they come here, they attend the first month of the program, come into this program, online program, attend the first 1 month of classes in the program, submit the assignments, and then appear for the first, equivalent of our first quiz. They have to appear for the first quiz at the end of 1 month. And in the first quiz, whoever passes, which is more than 50% mark, is qualified. So there is no ranking. We don't say only the top 2,000 will get in. But you really have to be fairly good to actually get to this top, to clear that 50% mark. You have to really learn the content well. And the content is not, it is set to bring a school level student up to speed, but it is not child's play, so to speak. They have to really put in their effort. They have to work diligently to get that 50%. But if they do, they are in. We have no other restrictions. This is a program that the IITs put out as one of those situations where if you are interested in an IIT level education, and if you are willing to work hard, you are willing to show your interest in the program, then you can be in. We don't have any other restrictions. You don't have to go to some coaching class somewhere. You don't have to work for years to get your foot into the door. You're interested, you're willing to work hard, you're sincere, and you have interest in this program, there's a good chance that you can actually participate in this program. So we have this. We also have a direct entry to diploma. Various features of this program are there. I encourage you to see our website, onlinedegree.iitm.ac.in. I'll flash it at the end of this presentation. We just have a few more slides. I'll close with that. And you can see many of these features. But basically, three levels and three different exit points. And if you complete the BSc degree, then you become an alumnus of this institute. The content is shared in an online mode, but the exams, every month there is an exam, and this exam is in person. So we are really rigorous about how we evaluate this program and how we evaluate any student in this program. This is just a snapshot of the kind of courses we have. I won't go into great detail. But the second year, which is the diploma year, is the key year where all the major courses associated with this program are offered. And so, in fact, somebody who is a professional in a professional organization can and who has a bachelor's degree from some prior education can directly do this diploma year if they want. And in which case, in 6 months to a year, they may be able to boost their professional contributions in their organization. So as I mentioned, we just finished our first round. About 30,000 students have applied. They had the qualifications of, minimum 12th standard and some other qualification we had asked for. They attended 4 weeks of classes. And on 22nd of November, 20,000 of those students in India and about 84 students in UAE, were able to take the exam. Many candidates from other countries have expressed interest. But at the moment, we don't yet have exam centers set up in other countries. And that's really the only limitation. We are working on it. In fact, again, I would like to use this opportunity to reach out to all of you to also help us in this. If you know exam operating agencies in various countries, we will still run the exam. We know what we need. We know how to test their system so that it works as per our requirements. And we can run this exam at various places. So we are steadily expanding. We are looking at places in the US, in Singapore, various other places. Of course, we have to synchronize the timing. So that is a bit of an issue, but we will work around it. And these are the processes that are going on. Our second round of admission starts in December this year. This month. A little later in this month, we will open for more admissions. And this has really been a major contribution in terms of our intent to provide high quality, large scale education from one of the best institutes in India to basically everybody in India. And in fact, everybody internationally. People can come to us. If you are keen on the education, you can get it. So I will close with this slide. That's our site, onlinedegree.iitm.ac.in. Please visit this if you want to see more details. And it's been my pleasure to share with you this journey of the general online degree, the general online education process that IIT has been involved in, and the very specific and brand new online degree that we have initiated. Again, thank you for joining us this evening. I'm done. If there are, as we discuss, we'll have, I'm sure, more interaction as we go forward. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you, Mr. Pratap. So we'll quickly take some questions. So we have Vikram Batra, who says, as knowledge is becoming more democratized, should IITs focus more on online certifications or even look at vocational skill building that enhances employability?
So actually, I think there is a skill building program also. Professor Mangal Sundar is actually coordinating that. And there may be other initiatives too. There is a little bit of a, you have to think a little carefully on where exactly we want to go with it. Because we bring certain strengths to the table in terms of rigor and the quality and the depth of education that we provide. So whether we want to focus our energy where our strength is or try out something that maybe others are also looking at is something that we have to look at. But it is certainly an area that is being explored.
Yeah, thank you. So here's another question. One second. Sorry for this. So will this be called a regular degree or something on correspondence?
Yes. So when the students graduate after 3 years with a BSc degree, that is an official degree from IIT Madras. So this is an official degree. It is a Senate approved degree from IIT Madras, and it is just as valid as any other degree that IIT Madras is offering.
It will not say correspondence on the degree.
Yes, it will not say correspondence on the degree.
Okay. So can we create a specific program for alumni to get lifelong learning certification in specific domains?
Absolutely. Can I answer that, Pratap?
Sure.
One of the thoughts that we are playing with is, given this whole bank of knowledge that is available for free, we want to create a pathway by which our alumni can continuously upgrade themselves along the way and be connected with their alma mater in that process. So, yes, we are, all of the minor streams that Pratap talked about, the minor bunches of courses are a step in that direction, that an alumnus can step up, take the bunch of courses and equip themselves in that specific domain. So there are domain specific courses that you can do, or a whole degree program. We also now have web enabled MTech programs. For those that are BTech graduates can now do a complete MTech online, but those programs are only enabled through their employers. So, but they are available for our alumni to seek through their employers.
Okay. So Harshit wants to know, can I do master's from abroad degree and an online BSc degree?
So the online BSc, the master's.
Can somebody, can somebody do 2 degrees at a time? Because that's another question up.
So the way we have set it up is that you can do this alongside any other degree that you're doing. So in fact, the courses that we offer are offered on 3 terms every year. So there's a set of courses which start in January, then again in May, and then again in August. So you have 3 opportunities in a year to keep taking your courses. So if you're enrolled in some other program, during the Jan and August semester, you can take less of courses from the online program. And in the summer break, when you have maybe more time, you can take more courses with us. So it is specifically designed to enable people who are already doing something else to also do this alongside.
Okay. And How about the access to the online library?
Yes, we are working on it. We have, in fact, because this is the first batch, this exact same request was raised by several students. And we are in the process of setting up that access and figuring out exactly what we will have available. So it is very much in the works. It's not yet there at the moment.
Okay, so here's a very different question, I guess. Does the progress of a nation depend only upon the brilliant brains working together, or it also needs the cooperation of the average brains? So how will the evaluation be done in this case?
I'm not sure if that is specific to the online program or general, but yeah, please, Mahesh, general, please go ahead.
So I think I want to mention that all of us are, IITs have brilliant people, there's no doubt about that, but these institutions are meant for everybody. And this online degree program is a particularly stark example of that vision with which IITs were built. They were never intended to be egalitarian, limited access institutions. We just didn't have the technology to go teach, like Pratap said, 16,000 students across the country. We now have the technology and we are quickly leveraging it to build the world's first. Now, the key word that in what Pratap said, this is the world's first undergraduate program, fully online program in data science. Can you believe it that an Indian institution is doing the world's first such program? And you can see what kind of a global ripple this can create. And that's exactly what Pratap and team are working on, to leverage this program and the first mover advantage to create a global ripple. I think we're going to see more of these worlds first come out of IIT Madras in the next few years.
Lata, just to add a couple of comments, sure. Also to build on what Mahesh just mentioned, in fact, in online education, as best as we can see, IIT Madras and the NPTEL program have really set themselves up as being world leaders and pioneers in this area. So actually, most of the time, we tend to think that somebody else got it done somewhere else, and we are just making an Indian version of it. We have got a lot of unique activities in this online mode. Where we are really the first in the world to do it. It's really been a very nice learning experience because as I said, we find excellent students in all small towns and smaller cities where they will not have the capability to access the kind of coaching processes that are required for people to enter into IITs. They do very well in many of these courses where the exam is conducted by an IIT Madras faculty or an IIT faculty, may not be IIT Madras, it could be an IIT faculty from anywhere in the country. And it's a very rigorous exam. They do well. So we are really happy that we are able to do that. We are able to reach them. And without this process, those students would not be able to access our faculty, and our faculty will not be able to access those students. This entity has enabled that to happen.
So here are some different questions. Did you learn anything surprising in the NPTEL journey? And what's the biggest challenge faced by NPTEL? And what are some of the feedback received from learners so far?
Okay. So I wouldn't say a surprise, but it was a pleasure to actually, discover discover this point that we were probably always suspecting, that there are good students everywhere who may not have the fluency of speaking to us, who may not have the confidence, social confidence to present themselves to us, but who are actually very good, very hardworking, and sincere about their education all across the country. So that has been a pleasure and privilege to find. It's been a very pleasant surprise. In all corners of the country, we have all the way from Jammu Kashmir to Kanyakumari to the Northeast to Gujarat, everywhere we have excellent students. And our teachers are delighted to reach out to them. In fact, thanks to NPTEL, many of the IIT faculty are recognized wherever they go amongst general public, I would say. So there are many instances where the faculty are thrilled by just this personal touch that they are somewhere and some student walks up to them and says, I have been taking your classes. at really, I mean, places where they never expected, where they go on a tourism trip and they have some person walk up to them and say, I have taken your class. And so that's been very eye-opening. We have had feedback from senior people who are, in fact, very well known, who have done some background reading for their knowledge and have used one of the NPTEL courses for it. And then they send a thank you message saying, this has made a difference to me. I was trying to look up this information for something and your course helped us with it. It also helps bridge many gaps. I mean, unfortunately, we still have all the national boundaries. We still think that, there is some boundary beyond that. We have people who are not, not good people, so to speak. And this bridges gaps. We have people from Pakistan, from Bangladesh, from, many places in the Middle East, who are all taking our courses. And they communicate with us. They are so thrilled that they're able to access us and chat with us and so on. And all this has been a very nice journey. Challenges, we are still trying to reach out to more places. We find even at 1,000 rupees, which is a very nominal fee, there are students who have challenges accessing this content. And so we have arranged CSR funding for them. For the online program also, we find many students who have come in the first batch, the 30,000 who have come, appear to be from middle-class families, so they have access to good internet connections. We are trying to bridge, go beyond that. We would like to reach into places where maybe internet is not good to begin with. And so that is a challenge now. I think our infrastructure is still improving. And so that's still something that we have to work with.
Yeah, I think as you were talking about this, we have a nice comment here from Rahul Parikh, who says, I'm a student of this online degree from a remote village. And it's really great. Thanks, IITM, for such a great vision.
Lovely
to hear. So I think that's a lovely thing to hear. And actually, there are multiple questions on placement. What kind of is there a placement assistance to this, or is NPTEL or IIT trying to get in something with the government, the foreign governments, where they can say that this validates them to get a job? Is there any kind of MOUs being signed? So there are multiple questions being asked on this placement. So what's your
So placement, I will address it in two aspects. One is the NPTEL side and the other is the online BSc aspect. The NPTEL aspect, which is the larger program, we have not had a formal placement process. We have feedback from a lot of people who have used that it helped them in their placement process, but we have not formally set up yet. I mean, we will work on it, but we have not formally set up a placement process from the NPTEL side. On the online BSc degree front, which is then a formal degree from IIT Madras, we are going to have a placement cell. We are going to have a placement process, which will be in addition to the IIT Madras placement process for the students who graduate from the online BSc degree program. And so there we are actively working with people from the industry to see what interest that they have. In fact, we expect that the top few students who, when they come towards the final year, will get an opportunity to actually intern with companies and work with faculty in person in the campus. And that should make a significant difference to their placement process.
Okay, that's interesting. So will there be any letter of recommendations that will be given is one question, and how this degree will be beneficial after 3-4 years, I think we've...
Yeah, so, I mean, of course, once they are students of the program, they will, like every other student, you get the legitimate right to start asking your professor for a letter of recommendation. So I'm sure at that point, that would be part of the process. From everything that we have, found out with discussion with a lot of people in the industry, this is an area where they desperately seek specialists. They desperately seek people who are trained in this area, programming and data science. And it's an area that is just expanding very rapidly across, I would say internationally, it has been expanding. The demand for people in this area is expanding dramatically. The supply is nowhere close. I mean, people are just, trying to learn on their own on the side and trying to make do. So supply is nowhere close and is not heading anywhere close. The gap is only widening. So therefore, we are quite confident that the students who graduate from here have excellent opportunities available for them ahead.
Yeah. So we have Mukesh Kumar here from IBM. So he says in IBM itself, they discriminate the online courses as correspondence courses. So does this mean that irrespective of any MNC, they could just go ahead and say this is a regular course and not an online course?
So I think that's a good question. So what we have done, again, as I said, is that the assessment is in person and it's rigorous. So I would say this is a mixed mode operation. At the end of the day, the you know, the online assignments that they give is simply a form of you know, attendance requirement or something to make sure that they're doing some regular progress. But every month, the exam that they write is exactly the way an IIT exam runs, where you go to your class and you sit with invigilators and you write your exam. So we are very particular that we are going to ensure that there is absolutely no dilution of the rigor of the process. So when somebody graduates and shows you a certificate, you can expect quality. That is our goal. We are not interested in numbers. Even though I have shown you a lot of numbers, I said with great you know, delight that we have 1 billion hits on our site. We have 30,000 people who are who have applied for this program. We are really not after numbers. We want the outreach, but we are focused on quality. And we want to provide the quality in such a way that the students can climb up to the expectation that is there of the output of this program. But the person who comes out will be solid. And we expect that they will go and prove themselves. Like any other program, we are confident that if we put out the good product, they will go and prove themselves. The certificate is not going to talk of online or correspondence. The certificate is going to be a solid certificate from our side, which simply says that it is a BSc in programming and data science. So that is the certificate they're going to have. And then the world is going to find out how good they are. We are confident that they will be good. Okay. And we in fact, I would be happy to invite people to come and see our process. They can even come to our exam centers if they are interested. We can take them around and show them what goes on. And they can satisfy themselves that this is a very rigorous process.
Yeah, so here's another question. Does IITM consider introducing sign language for the courses to facilitate hearing impaired students to pursue this online degree program?
Okay, we have not looked at that. That's a good suggestion. We have, in India, the challenge has been translating it into Indian languages itself. So we are, at the moment, there is some effort to provide subtitling and at least a transcript in various Indian languages. So that a student from a town where they have learned in, say, Tamil or Bengali or Malayalam can also still at least understand the concept more easily in their language that they're comfortable with and go forward with that. We have not looked at sign language. It is a bit complicated because it's a lot of technical content that we are presenting. Of course, nothing is impossible. We have just not looked at it. We have not put in the effort in that direction yet. We will certainly look into it.
Yeah. So these are not questions, but I definitely would like to read out some of the comments and you'll be happy to hear it. So we have Vinod Vasan who says, I've done my MS Computer Science from California State University. I have recently joined BS Data Science and Programming at IITM. I can confidently say that the quality of education at IITM is top-notch. And we have Jaydev who says, it wasn't in my wildest dreams that I would be doing an IITM course with 3 exclamatory marks. It has really helped me in many ways as most of these concepts were new to me. I'm a working professional and thank you so much for giving back that school days experience.
Our privilege.
So now we have a question again from Prakash who says, thinking 10 years ahead, any thoughts on how you at NPTEL good linkage of education to innovation and impact?
Yes, so that is a tricky question in the sense, yes, because this needs in-person processes. We have not really explored that completely. I mean, there is interest to bring you know, companies, industries to participate with us in the course offering. So there is a chance that we will get the toppers of the courses to do projects in those companies. And so maybe in that process, we'll have some innovative aspects also as part of the process in that company. Separately, as an innovation aspect, we have not looked at in great detail. We may have courses in that direction, not seriously looked at it. Maybe Mahesh has something to add on it.
Yeah, I think you know, innovation is a very, it's a very difficult word to wrap our thoughts around, right? I mean, some of us may believe that it is just people are just born innovative, and others may say, No, it can be learned. So let's assume for a moment it can be learned. And the way we learn it is essentially by tinkering and by doing. I get this brainwave and I want to go flush it out into a product, build something, right? And right now we have on our campus a Center for Innovation that Pratap and I helped advise some time ago. That is our students' outlet. Now, I can easily see those kinds of centers being sprinkled all over the country where these students can go spend an hour, spend 2 hours to get their creative juices flowing. I think it's a matter of finding the right business model. And my guess is within a year or two, if these kinds of online degree programs take off in a big way, you will see similar degree programs in physics, in chemistry, which require labs. And the moment you start to engage labs, you'll start to see tinkering labs come up as well. I think it's a matter of time before we see that in a large country that is demanding good education from its educational institutions.
Yeah, so we have a question from Yogendra Singh, who is actually a student of this program. We answered this, but then again, for the benefit, I read this out again. Will the students be getting an IITM email ID and ID cards so that they can access to various free softwares and tools helpful for data science and AI?
Yes. So we just finished this qualifier exam on 22nd of November, and our results are expected, like I said, in about 3 days' time. Once the results are out, all those who are qualified for the first year of the program will get an official IIT Madras email ID, and they will also get an official IIT Madras online degree program ID card. So both of them will become available. Online content, we are working on online library and resources. We are working on the details of it. Yes, some of it will definitely be available.
Yeah, I think that helps you, Yogendra, because he says it's been a pleasant journey so far and it's a great learning experience. So I'm sure he's going to enjoy all this. Yeah. So there are some good things. Again, it's good to know that IITM is exploring possibilities of conducting exams outside of India too. This will definitely give students the flexibility to take up jobs abroad and also study and finish degrees on time. I think there has been a very positive, and people are very happy about what we are doing. And I think we are coming to the end of the question sessions here. Anything else?
You know, okay. One of the new normal, you know, talk yeah. of driving the new normal. I can't imagine anything bigger than this, driving mm-hmm. the new normal. IIT mm-hmm. Madras is defining what education and degree granting in the new normal will look like. It's easy to redefine education, to say knowledge delivery. You know, a lot of edutech companies are doing it. A lot of educational institutions are doing it. But to figure out a high quality degree granting process, I cannot imagine anything better than that as defining the new normal for IIT Madras, Lata.
Yeah.
And I also sure. just want to add, Lata, that, you know, yeah. again, I take this opportunity to invite everybody to both utilize these opportunities, NPTEL and online degree, and also help us by, you know, participating in it, by, you know, collaborating with our faculty to co-offer courses and so on. So many possibilities exist. So please feel free to, you know, reach out to us, and we will be delighted to share with you details on how you can, you know, be part of it and share this journey with us.
So there's a question here where Harshit wants to know if students will have opportunities to do campus tours while during the degree. So what is their access to the yes. facilities on campus?
Yeah, so we are, that is definitely one of the ideas that we have. We have to see how to space it out to make sure that everybody gets some, you know, access to come in and visit our labs and so on. We will, again, this is our very first batch. So many ideas are there that we are working on. As the numbers become clear, as the logistics of it all becomes clearer as we go forward, we will roll them out. And every one of these, we fully appreciate the interest, the thrill in the process. And we are very much keen on ensuring that many of these things happen.
Yeah. So there is also a question on what's the possibility of having an online degree program for MSc in mathematics. So I think there's a lot going to come up.
Yeah. So definitely, see, I will put it this way. This area, we did a lot of homework and we started off this program. For IIT Madras and for the IIT system as a whole, This is a new experiment in terms of how it runs, how well it runs, how well the community uses it, the learning community uses it, how well it is accepted by the world around us, and so on. So it may take a batch or two of people going through this process and graduating and word getting around on how it's all happening. And you will see more such programs opening up. I think there's a lot of interest to do so, but they're waiting for our, so we have to get it right. We really have to get it right and do a good job because this is a beautiful start for education, opening in education for all of us. And we have to get it right because it's a model that can be built on. And we're working very hard on ensuring that.
Okay. So, I mean, we have answered this, but then again, somebody asks, is this sufficient for creating a good career in data science? How employable will they be?
Yeah. We believe it's a good starting point. Building a career is entirely in your hands because you have to go to the workplace and show what you can do with these skills that you have learned. We are confident. We have excellent faculty, both from within the IIT system and collaborating institutes who are participating with us. We have excellent faculty. They will give you the best that you can possibly get in this area in terms of an education. And our process will be rigorous. So when you clear it, you will have that confidence that you have actually learned something. We also have other supporting courses which will help a person present themselves at interviews and so on. So a lot of such courses are also there. So we are confident that we will give you the right platform when you graduate from here, that you can feel good that you are ready for what is out there. After that, it is in your hands. You have to go and show what you have got and how you are going to utilize it. And that will create the career.
Can I just add one thought? One of the key ingredients in this day and age of building a successful career is having a good network. And that network starts with your alumni, your fellow students who graduated with you. And the moment you get this degree, you will become part of the same alumni network that I am part of, or Pratap is part of, or that all of you are part of. So you will have the full strength of the complete alumni network to help you. And I think that is a remarkable strength that you can rest on to build your career.
Yes, that's, I think, very, very well stated. Yeah.
Yeah. So we have a question from Dhatri Medari who asks, would we be able to participate in technical and non-technical events conducted at IITM?
So the technical, non-technical events at IIT Madras are events where they have a wide range of entry criteria. So it is not, so when there's a tech fest in IIT Madras, for example, it is actually open to students from essentially all over the country, even all over the world. So in a sense, if that is one of the things you wish to do, you are free to do it right now. You don't have to actually be in any program to participate in that. Even any conference that is there, I mean, if you have got some technical content to present and you qualify, you can present. So this is not maybe directly related, is what I would like to say.
Yeah.
On a humorous note, I want to say that this is like when we say goodbye and we stand at the door and then speak for another 15 minutes. Lata said goodbye, and then when we have very enthusiastic question asker and question answer giver, this thing. But I'm just commenting on a humorous note. Lata, please go ahead.
Yes, please. Yeah, I think with that we come to the end of today's sessions and. Thank you, Professor Mahesh. Thank you, Professor Pratap, for such a wonderful session. I think and it was really nice to have a lot of students here who have been through this course and giving us firsthand information. And there are questions about various courses which is coming up. I think IIT Madras has just started, and we'll have more courses year on year. And maybe we'll do a one full day session on all the online programs of IIT Madras next year. Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much. And thank you, each one of you, for joining us today. Do watch out our agenda session for a very interesting line of speakers for tomorrow's sessions also. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, Lata. Thank you, Chris.